My name is Cameron Nakashima. I'm the Media Engagement and Digital Campaigns Manager at Better Business Bureau. I've been here about 3 months, and Better Business Bureau is here to help customers and shoppers be smart and safe when shopping in the marketplace and online. That is correct. We are not a government agency. We are a not-for-profit agency or a not-for-profit organization that is here to help protect the consumer and educate the consumer. Absolutely. So the pig butchering scam, it's gotten a lot of press lately. It's been around for a while, but it's a little bit different from some of the schemes that we've seen like it in the past. So a pig butchering scheme, it has nothing to do with pigs. It is all about luring a victim or a target in, and then they will fatten them up is the term that's been used. And really, it just means that they prime their target, the scammers do, get the person willing to spend more and more and more and more money, and then they kind of go in for the butchering at the very end. So what this all looks like in real life and you know, practically, is the first step for the scammer is they're going to set up a fake account. Usually it's on social media or a dating website. They're going to look very attractive. They're going to look very wealthy, and they're going to have a good number of followers, but these are all fake. Usually they've used maybe AI, or they've stolen somebody else's profile photos. So once they have their fake identity set, they're going to start messaging people, and they're going to reach out with a single message. It's unsolicited, but this person looks attractive and wealthy, and so a lot of people will bite at the conversation. And these conversations could look like anything from "Hi, how are you today?" Or it could be something a little bit more direct, like "Hey, it's fate has brought us here together," or something like that. So once the conversation is initiated, and let me back up by saying they can also reach out via text message. So that's something else we're seeing. There's no profile associated with this, but it's the exact same outreach approach. Once they've started the dialogue, they'll quickly morph the conversation into something very personal. They'll try to create a quick emotional connection with their target. And once that is effective, they're going to morph the conversation over to investing. And they're going to say, "Hey, you know how I'm on my social media accounts, I look like I'm so wealthy and I'm doing so well. Well, that's because I know how to invest, and I would love to teach you how to invest." And so quickly they start turning into almost a mentor role as far as the investment goes. But there's also this strong emotional connection that they've worked to establish. And from that point, they'll bring them over to where the butchering begins. And that's going to be a website that they set up. And it is a fake brokerage website for cryptocurrency. So they're going to tell their target, "Hey, here's a great opportunity, very high returns, very low risk. You just convert your money into cryptocurrency, invest it into this brokerage account," and they're going to pressure them to do it before they have time really to research it and know what they're investing in. And they'll say, "This is a proven win for an investment." Once they make that investment, they're going to they'll be a little bit hesitant, right? So they'll start with maybe a few $1,000 up front, and they'll play it. This is where the kind of the fattening of the pig analogy comes in, because they'll allow the person to withdraw their funds after they've deposited the funds, as long as they know that this person has more funds that they can obtain or liquidate. Once the person feels more comfortable with the experiment of putting in maybe $10,000, then they'll start investing more. And we've seen these amounts, go hundreds of thousands of dollars. And so they'll keep investing. And this guru of theirs is really putting the pressure on to say, "Hey, you've got to do this. This is the way to win, to get ahead in life." They'll convince people to do some really terrible things financially. They'll have them liquidate their retirement accounts. They'll have them pull out liens against their property, or just anything that could devastate a person financially. They're going to encourage that. They're going to encourage them to open up new credit cards and really just max out liquidation potential and the debt potential for that individual, invest as much as they can. And once they've maxed them out, then they go in for the butchering and the kill. And they say, the person tries to get their money out and the scammer cuts them off. They say, no, you can't get your money out. If you invest a little bit more, or if you pay this brokerage fee of maybe $40,000 to get your $400,000 out, then we'll let you have your money. And so then they pay that, and then some other new fee emerges. Perhaps this is now a tax fee or a handling fee. And so then they keep tacking on tens of thousands of dollars at the end while the person's trying to get it out, their money out. And this is where the sunk cost fallacy comes into play, where the person desperately wants to get their huge investment back out. And there's a huge part of their brain that says, this is a scam, this isn't real. But there's so much invested that many people just keep going. And the little bit that they did have that they're holding on to financially is then completely evaporated by the end of this. And once the scammer realizes that they've gotten as much as they absolutely possibly can from their victim, then they turn around and they reveal, hey, this whole thing was a scam. And in some cases, they'll even taunt the person and say, how could you fall for this? And they just really, you know, lean in abuse them emotionally after abusing them financially. And then they cut off any kind of ties. They shut down their fake accounts, turn off the fake website, because now they've got that cryptocurrency into their own account and they're able to do with it what they want. And then they just totally evaporate. So that is what a pig butchering scheme looks like. It's a lot of things involved as far as like what their motives are. We're not entirely sure, but it is this very targeted attack to get as much as they possibly can from a person. And it's proved to be effective for them. And so they're going to keep on doing it. And then, yes, at the very end, there is some very cruel, twisted piece of them at the end there that once they've already won, they want to turn the knife a little more just to, devastate the person even more, which is very cruel. So in regards to Hawaii, people who live in Hawaii, we've actually seen hundreds of thousands of dollars lost from them. One case in particular that got reported to Better Business Bureau Scam Tracker, somebody in Hawaii lost over $300,000 to a pig butchering scam. A couple ways that you can stay safe and spot these early is poor grammar in the messaging, unsolicited messaging from somebody you don't know, especially in the form of the text message. That is a huge red flag. If people text you out of the blue, you don't know who they are, the best thing you can do is not respond, because once they get you to respond, they start to build that relationship and things move quickly. Another thing to keep in mind is that you should not trust somebody who you meet online with investment advice, especially if they're the one who's holding your hand through the process and encouraging you to make those investments. If you do want to take investments seriously, whether it be with crypto or something a little bit more predictable, that should be done with somebody that you already know, you trust, you have a firm relationship with, somebody you've at least met in person. That's going to help protect you against this as well. Absolutely. Yeah. So we do have, if you want to learn more, we've got several blogs and articles out there about crypto investment schemes. So you can look into those. We also have our BBB.org, the scam tracker. And with the scam portion of our website, there's also tools to help people who have been devastated by scams. And so we've got a toolkit to help the person know what next steps to take financially, who else they can report it this too, and also what the next steps would be to recover emotionally. So as we talked about, this is a very manipulative scheme, and it can really do a lot of emotional and psychological damage to a person at the end of this. So there's tools on there as well to help point them in the right direction and get them started in that journey.